Alright, shalom semuanya, selamat pagi. I'd like to say welcome to Prayer Innovation Church for whoever just joined us for the first time today. We're so happy and glad to see you guys here, and we're hoping that you can grow together with us and to know Jesus together. We may be stand up for a second. I believe that Holy Spirit is here. We're just gonna pray so His Spirit can feel fresh on us this morning. Whatever your burden, your heart, your problem, your sickness, bring it to Jesus. You have to believe that He's always be with you. Percaya Tuhan bahwa Engkau hadir pada pagi hari ini. We wanna worship You, Jesus. We wanna worship You, Lord. Bring on Your voice. Bring Your heart to Jesus.
Because of Christ, I am alive. Oh. see the glory of God in this place. We set our gaze on the presence of Jesus. Holy Spirit, we invite you. We welcome you, Holy Spirit, to move in the middle of your people here. We really long to see your wonderful touch, your wonderful power, Jesus. As we believe your name is wonderful, Jesus.
Yeah.
Speak to us, my Lord. Send your anointing come upon us, upon me as a preacher, upon the translator who are going to translate this sermon into English, that the message will change our life. Your message will transform our lives to be more like you. Thank you, Lord. We commit this time into your hands. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Siapa orang percaya sama-sama bilang, amin. Berikan salam bagi Tuhan kita. Katakan Yesus luar biasa. Bilang, Yesus itu luar biasa.
Jesus is excellent and extraordinary. Amin.
Kalau gak keberatan sekali, kita berikan huge applause untuk Jesus kita. Amin. Katakan, I love you Jesus. Shalom Bapak Ibu.
Shalom ladies and gentlemen, brother and sister.
Bulan ini kita akan fokus kepada doa. Kita akan belajar banyak tentang doa. Okay.
This month we will focus over a lot about prayer.
Dan hari ini kita akan fokusin a man of prayer.
So today we going to focus our sermon and it's the title the man of prayer.
Bila sama-sama saya, a man of prayer.
Let's say it together, a man of prayer.
Siapa yang mau menjadi a man of prayer?
Who wants to be a man of prayer? Raise your hand please. Hallelujah.
Kita buka dulu Alkitab kita Daniel pasal 6.
Let's open our Bible in Daniel
Indonesia ayat 11 English verse 10.
So in Indonesian is verse 11, but in English
is
verse 10.
Saya lebih tertarik King James Version then.
Yeah.
Pastor Elia akan baca.
Okay, I will read in a King James Version. Now, when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went into his house and his windows being open in his chamber toward Jerusalem. He knelt upon his knees 3 times a day and prayed.
Three times.
And gave thanks before his God as he did aforetime.
Bahasa Indonesia saya nggak baca, tapi ayat ini ngajarin kita tentang doanya Daniel.
Yeah. I will not read in Indonesian, but this verse actually telling us about Daniel how he prayed.
Kalau kita bicara Daniel,
if we talk about Daniel,
seringkali nempel di kepala kita.
That always stick in our mind
adalah seorang yang ada di gua singa.
Sometimes we only remember Daniel as a man who was in the lion's den or the den of lions.
Kalau kita bicara Daniel, yang ada di kepala kita itu hanya ingat bahwa ada promosi jabatan yang dialami Daniel.
So if we talk about Daniel, what we have in our mind is the promotion and the position that Daniel had.
Tapi hari ini kita akan bicara soal Daniel, kita akan ingat bagaimana dia punya disiplin di dalam doa.
But today we're going to learn about Daniel, how he had discipline in prayer, in his prayer life.
Ayat ini berkata bahwa tiap hari dia berdoa 3 kali, Bapak Ibu.
This verse says every day he prays 3 times a day.
Orang kan bilang 3 kali mah biasa, tetangga kita doa 5 kali sampai COVID budek dan dengerin dah.
And many people say, oh 3 times is just normal. Do you know our cousin? You know our, the Muslim people, they pray 5 times a day.
Tapi yang menarik dari kisah Daniel ini, sekalipun dia dilarang, dia diancam untuk tidak berdoa, tapi dia tetap berdoa 3 kali sehari.
But what interesting about Daniel is, even though he is forbidden to pray, but he keeps praying 3 times a day.
Siapa yang mau berdoa, angkat tangan.
Who wants to pray? Can you please raise your hand?
Siapa yang mau tetap berdoa kalau diancam?
Who wants still praying even though you are threatened to be killed? Raise your hand.
Dengar baik-baik. Dengar baik-baik.
Listen carefully.
Daniel sekalipun dilarang diancam, tapi dia tetap berdoa.
Even though Daniel was forbidden to pray, he kept praying.
yang sedih itu begini. Orang Kristen gak ada yang larang, gak ada yang memperkusi, tapi gak ada yang doa.
What is sad is the Christian, all of us, nobody actually forbid us to pray and nobody actually threaten us. If you pray, I'm going to kill you. But still, not of us praying.
Antara doa dan dosa, bedanya ada S-nya.
Between praying and sinning, in Indonesian is actually only the different with the letter S.
Let the English speaking people say together with me. Doa.
Okay. The English, yang bahasa Inggris ayo bilang doa.
Satu lagi, dosa.
And in Indonesian, dosa. Dosa is sin, doa is to pray.
Orang lebih suka dosa daripada doa.
Ini. People would prefer dosa, which is sin, than doa, which is praying.
Tapi saya mau berita hari ini.
Today I want to tell you something.
Saya rindu melihat setiap pribadi di tempat ini.
I long to see every people in this place today.
Menjadi a person of prayer.
To become orang yang suka berdoa.
Yang mau bilang amin.
If you say yes, amen. If you want to say yes.
Waktu saya ke Israel,
when Pastor Johan was in Israel,
saya lagi berdiri di Western Wall.
I was standing in front of the Western Wall.
The Wailing Wall, the Western Wall, ya. Yeah. Saya berdiri di situ. Nah, saya ketemu beberapa orang Yahudi yang lagi berdiri, ada yang duduk.
And I saw many Jews in the Western Wall. They were praying and they were like this.
Terus duduk di meja, ada ininya.
They were sitting on the table, on the chair on the table, and there were like a prayer in front of them, and they were like this.
Saya nanya kepada mereka lagi duduk, saya tanya ini.
And when I asked them, one of them, when they were sitting there, I asked them.
Apa itu dua buku di depanmu?
What is that two books in front of you?
Dia bilang, yang satu buku doa, yang satu buku Taurat.
He replied, the first one is the prayer book, and the second one is Torah.
Dan itu yang tiap hari mereka lakukan, buku doa, buku Torah.
Then that's what they do every day, prayer book and the Torah book, the first five testament in the Old Testament.
Oktober itu banyak hari besarnya Israel sebenarnya.
Do you know in October there are many celebrations in Israel, feast in Israel.
Dan yang terakhir tanggal 24-25 kemarin mereka merayakan Simchat Torah.
And in the 24th and 25th October they actually celebrated what we call Simchat Torah. They were jumping around, they were dancing around.
Jadi kalau orang Israel kalau nyanyi itu.
So the Israelites when they sing they actually jumping around and dancing around.
Di sini ya.
Iya. Yeah.
Bapak ibu nyanyi.
Amen.
Oh, masuk.
Yeah, I expect people also singing when you sing. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul.
Rematik hilang.
I guarantee your arthritis will be gone in Jesus' name. Amen.
Yang punya sakit gelut tuh.
If you have injury or pain in your knee.
Praktek jumping nyanyi.
Yeah. Let's practice that. Every week when you sing, you jumping around for God.
Pasti sembuh.
I guarantee it will be healed in Jesus' name. Amen.
Tadi saya dengar saksi Pak Uki.
Yeah, and I heard the testimony from Mr. Luki.
Uki.
Uki, sorry. Uki. Uki.
Pak Uki itu ginjalnya kemarin turun seberapa waktu yang lalu 15 kan? Itu udah diancam untuk cuci darah.
Mr. Yuki, previously his kidney function was only 15%.
Saya cuma bilang sama dia, yuk doa yang banyak, saya bilang.
And Mr. Yuki, doctor say you going to have dialysis. But and then Pastor Johan told him, you have to keep praying, lots of praying for you.
Hari ini pagi saya tanya ini.
This morning I asked him.
Gimana Pak Yuki?
Mr. Yuki, how is your kidney now?
Naik jadi 17.
Function up by 2%, 17% now.
Ayo Pak Yuki, kalau nyanyi.
Okay, Mr. Yuki, when you sing, you have to jump around for God. Amen.
Nanti Tuhan juga kasih kesembuhan ya.
Amen. So God will give you a complete healing in Jesus' name. Amen.
Nah, jadi mereka baca buku doa, buku Torah.
So they actually read the prayer book and Torah book.
Sincha Torah itu adalah peringatan perayaan habis mereka baca Alkitab selama setahun. Jadi mereka rayakan namanya Sincha Torah.
Yeah. So Sincha Torah is the celebration of the Israelites after they read the prayer book and Torah book for a year, one year, then they celebrate it.
Yang aneh,
the weird thing is,
ada orang Kristen,
there are Christians,
40 tahun ikut Tuhan,
40 years following God,
40 tahun ikut Tuhan,
30 years following God,
20 tahun ikut Tuhan,
20 years following God,
5 tahun ikut Tuhan,
5 years following God.
Katanya udah habis baca Alkitabnya.
When I ask them, have you finished reading Bible yet?
Jawabannya belum.
They say not yet.
Tapi hari ini,
but today,
kita mau doa banyak, baca Alkitab.
Amen.
Rutin tiap hari. Amen. Yang percaya beramal.
Amen. We will pray and we will routinely read our Bible. Amen.
Akibatnya,
as the result,
itu bangsa Yahudi, Bapak Ibu.
The Jews,
itu dikenal bangsa yang pandai.
Is known for a smart nation.
Dikenal sebagai bangsa yang berhasil berada di papan atas dari perekonomian dunia.
Yeah. They are famous of being the top of the economic in the world.
Success.
They are successful.
Siapa itu?
Who are they? Can you give example?
Albert Einstein.
Can you remember Albert Einstein?
They are one.
They're the scientist.
Kita ingat siapa lagi?
And
kita
remember.
Ingat siapa lagi ya? Saya ingat misalnya Mark Zuckerberg, ya kan?
And also we remember Mark Zuckerberg.
Siapa dia?
Who is this person?
Facebook.
The Facebook founder.
Bisa main Facebook tapi gak kenal siapa founder-nya.
You play Facebook but you don't know Mark the founder of Facebook.
Franz Kafka.
Franz Kafka.
Itu penulis buku-buku terkenal dan novel-novel kelas dunia.
And also a famous writer and the world novel.
Siapa Steve Ballmer?
And who is Steve Ballmer?
CEO-nya Microsoft.
The CEO of Microsoft Company.
Siapa Sergey Brin?
Who is Sergey Brin?
Dia adalah co-founder daripada Google.
He is the co-founder of Google Company.
Siapa Michael Dell?
Who is Michael Dell?
Itu pencipta Microsoft Computer Dell.
That is the creator of Dell Computer.
Masih banyak yang lain, Pak.
And lots of other the Jews, famous Jews.
Saya percaya komunitas di tempat ini juga akan menjadi orang yang smart, orang yang sehat, karena bergaul dengan Tuhan lewat doa.
I believe the community in this church will be smart, will be successful because fellowship intimate with God and with apa itu? Prayer.
Kita itu ya, tiap hari Tuhan kepingin setiap kita itu disuruh apa ya, bergaul dengan Tuhan secara setia lewat doa.
Yeah. God asks us to always intimate with God and fellowship with God through our prayer.
Butuh satu komitmen.
You need one commitment.
Maka tiap pagi saya bilang bolak-balik, komitmen saya kalau pagi saya nggak mau tekuk-tekuk handphone duluan. Saya cari Tuhan duluan.
Many times I actually say that in the first thing in the morning, I will not find my phone, but I will pray God.
Yang kedua butuh sacrifice.
And the second one you need sacrifice.
Sebab tanpa sakrifikasi kita nggak bisa untuk pelihara jam-jam doa kita.
Because without sacrifice, we cannot maintain our prayer time.
Ada bayangan pulang kerja capek kan?
Yeah, can you imagine when you go back from work, you feel tired and exhausted, right?
Tapi kalau kita punya komitmen, punya sacrifice, kita akan tetap bisa berdoa.
But if you have a commitment and you sacrifice, we will still be able to pray. Amen.
Dan yang ketiga,
and the third one,
butuh kerinduan, Bapak Ibu.
You need the longing and the yearning.
Anda masih ingat ketika dulu pacaran?
Yeah, you remember when you still dating? You remember?
Coba flashback dulu, balik.
Okay, let's flashback to when you still dating.
Anda bisa bayangkan kalau kenapa ada orang itu terus rindu ketika pengen ketemu aja ya, nge-text, apalagi kepengen ngajak makan, jalan-jalan, pokoknya pengen ketemu aja terus itu.
Yes, you imagine when you were dating your partner before you getting married, you always longing and yearning to meet her, you text her or him, you're sorry. So yeah, you always want to see her or him.
Karena kita punya apa? Kering.
Because we have the yearning and the longing.
Kalau kita kangen sama Tuhan ya, kita kepingin ketemu aja sama Tuhan.
So if we long to see God and we yearn to see God, of course we want to see God all the time.
Saya mau nanya istri-istri. Saya mau nanya para istri-istri.
The wives.
Ya, yang kawinnya udah 40 tahun ke atas. Kita ada beberapa omong-omongan 40 tahun ke atas.
If you already married for 40 years, I know some of you already married for more than 40 years.
Saya tanya istri-istri.
And I want to ask the wives.
Masih kangen enggak sama hatimu?
Do you still miss or do you still long to see your husband?
Sedih loh kalau saya tanya sudah umur tua-tua. Kangen enggak? Enggak dong.
The sad thing is if I ask the seniors, the one who already married for a long time, do you miss your husband? And they say, sadly they say, not really.
Itu bahaya, Bapak.
That is very dangerous.
Sama Tuhan juga begitu, kita mesti punya kerinduan baru kita sama punya gairah mencari Dia.
So it's with God, to God, we need to have the longing and the yearning to see Him all the time. Amen.
Yang mau bilang mau begitu, mau.
If you agree, say, yes, I want to see God. Amen.
Tahu ya kalau kita berdoa ini ya, saya membagikan ada lima loh, lima dampaknya itu. Yeah.
Do you know if you really want to pray and want to have commitment to pray, there are five outcomes, results of your prayer. What are they?
Yang pertama.
The first one.
Dan telah buka ayat yang keempat Indonesia.
Yeah. Let's see first four in Indonesian, five in English.
Indonesian dulu saya baca.
Sorry, three in English. Third. Indonesia.
Oke, Indonesia muncul. Maka Daniel ini melebihi para pejabat tinggi dan para wakil raja itu karena ia mempunyai apa? Roh yang luar biasa. Dan raja bermaksud menempatkannya atas seluruh kerajaan.
Now in first in English is verse 3, ya, Daniel 6 verse 3. Then this Daniel was preferred above the presidents and the princes because an excellent spirit, so that the word is, he has an excellent spirit, was in him. And the king thought to set him over the whole realm.
Jadi yang pertama kalau kita pelihara jam doa kita.
So the first thing that if you maintain your prayer time, prayer life, what happened?
Cuma kita pasti akan menjadi orang yang excellent.
So we will become a person who has an excellent spirit. Amen.
Siapa yang mau?
Who wants to have excellent spirit?
Apa artinya excellent?
Do you know what's the meaning of excellent spirit?
Excellent itu.
Excellent.
Artinya extremely good.
It means extremely good, sangat-sangat baik.
Atau outstanding.
Or outstanding, are very very good.
Jadi kalau kita merajam doa kita,
so if we maintain our prayer life,
anda sedang berjalan ke sebuah proses menjadikan seorang yang sangat excellent.
And you are walking toward the process to become an excellent spirit person.
Ya, percaya bilang amin.
Saya
yakin bahwa Tuhan itu akan membuat setiap kita menjadi orang-orang yang extremely good.
I believe, I trust that God actually want us and want to make us become an extremely good person. Amen.
Saya punya teman.
I have a friend.
Yang berapa minggu yang lalu
few weeks ago he was preaching in this pulpit in here.
Masih ingat Pastor Eddie Leo?
Do you remember Pastor Eddie Leo from Indonesia?
Berapa itu yang datang ke sini? Lupa saya.
Do you remember the day?
August kayaknya.
Maybe August.
Anaknya salah satu anaknya itu.
One of his sons.
Itu nilainya kalau enggak 3-4 apa itu.
His son always got great like either 3 or 4 B.
Bagus nilainya.
So his son always get a bad score in his test.
Sampai satu kali bapak cuma bilang gini.
But one time the father said this to him.
Nah.
Child, son.
Baca Alkitab yang rajin.
You need to diligently read your Bible.
Doa yang rutin.
And also routinely pray.
Dan ternyata Tuhan mengubah kehidupannya.
Apparently God changed his life.
Dan saya akan lebih dalam tentang hal ini ya. Jadi ketika dia berdoa itu dia mengalami excellence. Dia memberikan dia spirit of excellence. Jadi
I will tell you more about this. So when he start to pray, he had an excellent spirit.
Kita tahu nggak nilainya Bapak Ibu?
You know the score of school mark?
Skornya naik nilainya Bapak Ibu.
It increased.
Saya percaya kalau di sini ada banyak orang yang juga gagal melulu. Yeah. Coba kita baca doa.
Amen. So I believe if here we have people who always fail at your prayer time.
Saya ketika waktu oblinger ya, long time ago.
When I applied for permanent resident long time ago.
Teman saya tuh oblinger itu bisa butuh waktu 2 tahun.
Do you know my friend when he applied permanent resident Australia, it took him 2 years.
Dan pada waktu itu jemaat belum ada Bapak Ibu, masih baru merintis tuh ceritanya.
Yeah. At that time the church was just starting. We don't have much people in the church.
Tapi tahu nggak Bapak Ibu?
Do you know what happened?
Kita berdoa kurang lebih 2 tahun.
We had been praying for at least 2 years.
Dan salah satu pengikut yang tidak pernah tidak datang.
Yeah. And one of the followers that never absent.
Jeffrey.
It's Pastor Johansson Jeffrey.
Jadi dia berdoa sama kita doain yang terjadi dalam 2 tahun itu Bapak Ibu.
He prayed and it happened in 2 years.
Bukan di gedung ini.
Not in this building.
Kita masih di Anglican Church.
We were still renting the Anglican Church building.
Gedungnya kan tinggi gitu ya.
The building was so high rise.
Gelap.
And it's very dark.
Kalau malam itu, wah gelap dan cuma ada angin.
In the night time is so scary because only can hear the wind.
Belum bagus. Belum lagi Bapak Ibu kalau hujan kenceng petir.
And also when it was raining, many lightning and you know thunders.
Tapi kita berdoa 2 tahun.
We prayed for 2 years.
Tahu nggak Bapak Ibu hasilnya apa?
You know what happened? What is the outcome?
Saya ngepray taruh seminggu untuk aplikasi.
I applied permanent resident for only a week.
Langsung saya dapat respon dari Departemen Immigration. Dia kasih suruh periksa kesehatan. Dia bilang.
A week later, the Department of the Health in Government of Australia responded to my application, asked the family to do medical checkup.
Anda bayangkan seminggu.
Can you imagine? Only it took a week, 1 week.
Kira-kira 10 hari kemudian.
And then approximately 10 days later.
Keluar hasilnya saya di granted.
Amen. It came out the result he was granted permanent resident of Australia just for one week.
Saya encourage semua di sini.
I encourage all of us here.
Apapun bentuk struggle kita.
Whatever your struggles are.
Coba bayar dengan jam-jam doa dan Bapak Ibu akan melihat amen. Tangan Tuhan nyata.
Amen, amen, amen. Just pray and pray and you will see the hand of God is real upon our life.
Yang percaya bilang amen.
If you agree say amen.
Itu excellent spirit.
That's the excellent spirit, roh luar biasa.
Dan yang kedua Bapak Ibu.
And the second one, what happened if you pray? The first five in Indo and the first four in English. First five in Indonesian and first four in English, yes. Then the presidents and princes sought to find occasion against Daniel concerning the kingdom, but they could find none occasion nor fault, for much as he was faithful, neither was there any error or fault found in him.
Kalau kita biasa melihara jam doa kita,
if we actually maintain our prayer time and life,
pastikan kita punya life value.
Make sure we have life value, nilai kehidupan.
Kenapa? Karena kita bergaul dengan Tuhan.
Because of what? Because we are having fellowship and intimacy with God.
Kalau kita bergaul dengan Tuhan,
if we have fellowship with God.
Enggak, kalau kita berteman seorang yang befriended someone atau befriended Tuhan, yeah. Yang terjadi kita akan jadi kayak dia.
Amen. If we befriended God, what happened? We will become like God. Amen.
Life value kita berubah.
Nilai kehidupan will be changed.
Dan dalam mengalami ada tiga diubahkan Tuhan. Yang pertama, dia jadi pribadi yang bisa dipercaya.
So Daniel experienced three things when he prayed. Number one, he became a personal that can be trusted like God can be trusted.
Seringkali well. Orang bilang, kau percaya Tuhan? Saya percaya Tuhan. Pertanyaannya, bisa enggak Tuhan percaya sama kamu?
Yeah, many people asking us, do you believe in God? And many times we say, yes I do, but can you be trusted just like God can be trusted?
Amen.
Amen.
Jadilah orang yang bisa dipercaya.
Let's become a person who can be trusted.
Karena Tuhan kita bisa dipercaya. Percaya belum? Amen.
Amen, amen. Because our God can be trusted. If you believe, say amen.
Selamat datang, Pak Richard, Bu Enda.
Welcome, Mr. Richard.
Saya bilang dia, Enda dan Richard ini, saya perkenalkan. Yeah. Ini orang yang pertama di PIC.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
Amen. Let me introduce you to Enda and Mr. Richard. These two person were two of the first people that came to PIC. Amen.
Saya datang di Perth pertama tinggal di rumahnya Mbak Enda.
When I came to Perth the first time, actually I stay with them in their house.
Dia sudah mereka pindah-pindah kok, step pindah step. Yeah. Pagi ini bilang mereka saya sering balik ke Perth lagi.
Interstate, but and this morning they told Pastor Mega I'm going to come back stay in Perth now.
Yeah, welcome, Richard yeah. And Enda. Jadi yang kedua adalah value.
So the second thing is the value of life.
Jadi kita punya nilai-nilai kehidupan.
So we have the value of love.
Bisa dipercaya.
Can be trusted.
Yang kedua itu berkata tidak korup.
Amen. The second one it says uncorrupted.
Tidak bikin rusak lingkungan kita.
We don't destroy our environment.
Renungkan Bapak Ibu.
Let's meditate and think about it.
Gimana dengan perkataan kita?
How about our words?
Gimana dengan sikap kita?
How about our attitude?
Apa impact-nya ke orang sekitar kita?
What are the impacts of our actions to our surroundings?
Tuhan kepingin setiap kita itu mendatangkan impact yang luar biasa kepada orang sekitar kita. Yang percaya bilang amin.
Amin. God wants us, our life, to have impact to our surrounding. If you believe, say amin.
Andrew John itu dikenal sebagai the leader, one of the leader of drug trafficking, Bali 9. Itu namanya Andrew John.
Do you remember Andrew John? One of the ringleaders of the drug trafficking, the Bali 9.
Dan bikin rusak banyak orang, Bapak Ibu.
He actually destroyed many people lives.
Malah obat-obatan yang dia selundupkan banyak orang yang mati sakit gara-gara obat-obat Yesus yang ditebarkan oleh Andrew Chan.
Yeah, Andrew Chan through his drugs, he actually killed many people because of the drug trafficking.
Waktu ditangkap di Indonesia,
when he was arrested in Indonesia,
banyak teman-teman kami yang ngijirin dia ke penjara.
Many of Pastor Johan's friend preach gospel to him in the prison.
Dan di penjara,
and in the prison, Roboan prison in Bali,
Andrew John mengenal Yesus,
knew Jesus Christ.
Dan yang terjadi apa? Tiap hari dia bangun kehidupan doanya, dia berdoa.
And what happened every day, every single day, Andrew Chan pray and maintain his prayer life.
Yang terjadi kehidupannya diubahin Tuhan.
What happened? His life was changed by God.
Itu banyak orang-orang yang menjadi image-nya dia di penjara itu bersaksi gini, kami sangat diberkati oleh kehadiran Andrew Chan di penjara ini.
Many inmates, his inmates in the prison, told us actually we were so blessed by the life of Andrew Chan.
Sejak itu dia bersama temannya itu Super Muron itu dia ajarin gambar, painting, ya, dia ajar lagi masak itu orang-orang di penjara itu dan mereka sangat diberkati.
Not only preaching the gospel, Andrew Chan actually taught the inmates how to draw paintings and how to cook. So many people were blessed by his life.
Saya Andrew Chan dan Miron Shikumaran itu akhirnya dihukum mati.
Yeah. Unfortunately, he and Miron Shikumaran still got death sentence. They were killed.
Tapi dampaknya sekarang masih.
But the impacts that they made still remember until now.
Kalau kita doa,
if we pray,
pasti kita bawa dampak yang kepada sekitar kita. Yang bersama kami.
Surely we will get, we will have impact for other people surrounding us. Amen.
Dan hanya kalau dibaca ketiga, dan itu tidak ada kelalaian.
In this verse, in the first 4 or 3, actually no mistakes can be found against Daniel.
Anda kalau suka berdoanya, ya.
Yeah. If you like to pray,
Bapak Ibu akan jadi orang yang cermat.
You will become a very careful, a very thorough person.
Bayangkan kalau kita jadi orang sembarangan, ya, terus di depan kita ada tombol rudal.
Imagine if we are very careless and in front of us there is a push button for a missile and we are not so wise enough, what happen?
Teman mau bikin sakit hati, pencet tombol.
If you get offended by someone, your friend, of course because you are not wise enough, you just press the button so the missile goes off.
Saya percaya kalau kita doa, kita akan jadi orang yang punya nilai-nilai dalam kehidupan kita. Yang percaya dengan amin.
So I believe if you keep praying, maintain your prayer life, we will become someone that have a life value. If you believe, amin.
Yang keempat.
Number 4.
Oh, ketiga ya. Tiga.
Number 3.
Ada tembok perlindungan.
There is a wall of protection from the Lord.
Tahu nggak? Daniel dicemplungi ke dalam lubang singa, tapi tidak ada satu pun singa yang lapar tadi bisa memangsa Daniel.
Do you know Daniel was thrown into the lion den, but not even one single lion could actually harm him?
Karena tembok perlindungan.
Because of the wall of protection.
Anda percaya ada tembok perlindungan?
Do you believe there is a wall of protection?
Percaya,
if you believe, raise your hand please. Wall of protection from the law.
Ada seorang misionaris yang bersaksi, dia balik ke negaranya, dia cerita di gereja lokal yang ngutus dia di Afrika.
There was a missionary actually went back to his local church in Michigan in United States and he gave testimony like this.
Dia bilang bahwa pengalaman dia ketika diutus di Afrika.
He said his experience when he was called, he went to Africa.
Dia melayani penduduk Afrika itu di sebuah pelosok, sangat apa ya, pedalaman gitu.
He actually served a remote part of Africa with the remote people in there, local remote people.
Dia bekerja di rumah sakit, dibantu di sebuah rumah sakit.
He worked in a hospital in there.
Nolongi orang-orang Afrika di pelosok, di pedalaman.
He actually helped African people in the remote of Africa.
Terus dia bersaksi gini kepada di gereja lokalnya.
Then he testified like this in this local church.
Dia 2 minggu.
Every 2 weeks.
Dia pasti pergi kota.
He went to city every 2 weeks.
Naik sepeda butuh waktu 2 hari.
He rode bicycle. It took him 2 days to go to city from the remote Africa.
Dan setiap kali kalau 1 hari dia pasti nginep di setengah perjalanan, nginep di sebuah hutan.
Then every time he always sleep over in a jungle on the way to city.
Nah, satu kali dia bilang gini, waktu saya ke kota untuk beli suplai makanan dan obat-obatan.
He told us the story one time when I went to city to buy the supply of medicine and food.
Dia melihat ada dua orang lagi berantem, pukul-pukulan sama itu.
He saw two people actually fighting, hitting each other.
Yang satu dipukul sampai pingsan.
And one person actually hit the other and the other almost fainted.
Tiga. Lalu dia datang diobatin Bapak Ibu orang ini, dirawat sama dia.
And he came to the person, attend the person and he actually treat the person.
Dan orang ini sembuh Bapak Ibu.
And this person was healed.
Dan dia melihat ini missionaries ini pergi ke bank ngambil duit, dia liatin ngambil duit.
And this person actually looked at the missionary. The missionary went to the bank, withdraw money.
Dan apa yang terjadi? Habis peristiwa, missionary pulang lagi ke pedalaman lagi kan, 2 hari.
What happened after the missionary withdraw money from the bank in the city? This missionary went back to the remote area again.
Dan 2 minggu kemudian,
2 weeks later,
dia balik ke kota lagi.
He went back to the city.
Lalu tiba-tiba ada beberapa kumpulan orang yang nyetop dia.
And suddenly there were a group of people stopped him in the middle of the road.
Salah satunya orang yang tolong dia tadi.
One of them was the person that he had helped before.
Dia bilang gini.
And he said this to him.
Kamu sadar nggak bahwa hari kedua kamu di hutan 2 minggu lalu?
Do you realize when the second day you were in the jungle 2 weeks ago?
Saya dan teman-temanku ini,
me and my friends,
lagi ngikutin kamu di hutan.
We were actually following you in the jungle.
Dan kami ingin bunuh kamu.
And we were going to kill you.
Ambil semua uang-uangmu.
Took all your money.
Ada bayangkan nih, orang yang tadi tolong loh.
Someone that actually he been helped, he helped before.
Lalu orang bersaksi begini.
And this person give testimony.
Pada saat kami akan rencana bunuh kamu.
When we were going to kill you.
Kami melihat ada 26 orang, dibilang 26 orang itu bercahaya begitu.
Yeah. We saw 26 people, so like a shining light in these 26 people.
Bawa senjata lengkap.
Carried a full weapon. And the missionary said, no, I was by myself, I was alone that time.
Aku melihat, tanya teman-temanku ini, semua bilang melihat 26 orang.
And the person that who want to kill him said, I actually saw 26 other people surrounding you with full weapon.
Ketika dia saksi begini,
when he gave testimony,
di gereja lokal tadi,
in the local church,
ada seorang jemaat yang berdiri.
And there was someone actually stood up.
Yeah, among the congregation ada satu orang yang stood up. Gitu.
So there was a person stood up on his feet.
Terus dia tanya, jam berapa itu?
And he asked him, What time was it?
Tanggal berapa itu?
What day was it?
Saya sebutkan tanggalnya, jamnya kan?
And he actually mentioned the date and the time.
Terus dia bilang gini.
And he said this.
Pagi itu kami tergerak, saya tergerak oleh Tuhan untuk berdoa untuk kamu.
Do you know, in that day, we actually prayed for you.
Dan saya mengajak teman-temanku untuk berdoa pagi itu untuk kamu, pelayanan misimu.
And I ask friends to come together to pray for your ministry.
Di gereja ini.
In this church.
Lalu dia berkata gini.
And he ask.
Teman-teman di sini yang pada waktu itu doa dengan saya, silakan berdiri.
And he ask. Those of you, if you pray with me to pray for this person, I want you to stand on your feet.
Tahu nggak Bapak Ibu?
Do you know?
Yang berdiri berapa?
Do you know how many people stood up?
Ini misionaris nggak lagi sempat cerita apa. Itu orang berdiri, dihitung sama dia.
And many people stood up and people counted.
Ini kalau Mbak Eda misionaris bilang gini. Cici loro papat limo.
Mrs. Eda is Javanese, maybe say cici loro means 1, 2, 3, 4.
26 Bapak Ibu.
26 people pray for this ministry in that time.
Kita harus percaya doa itu mengeluarkan dahsyat Bapak Ibu.
So we have to believe that prayer give a very example, a good result. Amen.
Nanti lain kali Bu Mega kalau khotbah silakan nanti Bu Eda cerita itu. Dia punya pengalaman juga khusus pada waktu kami berdoa dengan dia dengan keluarganya. Itu terjadi di Solo, ada sesuatu terjadi. Nanti kalau Bu Mega khotbah, Bu Eda yang akan kasih kesaksian ya.
Next time when Pastor Mega preach, Ibu Eda, Mrs. Eda can also testify about her experience in the city of Solo.
Saya percaya kalau kita berdoa, amen. Ada tembok perlindungan buat kita, amen.
Amen. I believe if we pray, there will be wall of protection surrounding us, amen.
Keempat.
The fourth one.
Kalau kita doa,
if we pray,
Tuhan dimuliakan.
Amen. God be magnified and glorified.
Kita tidak akan mungkin bisa memuliakan Tuhan kalau kita enggak berdoa.
Amen. We cannot glorify and magnify God if we don't pray. Amen.
Saya enggak punya waktu cerita kesaksian.
Yeah, I don't have time to tell you testimonies.
Saya langsung lari ke lima.
I'm going just to go to number 5.
Yang kelima terakhir.
The fifth one.
Kalau kita berdoa,
if we pray,
Anda akan bertumbuh jadi orang disegani.
Amen, amen. You will grow to become a respected people.
Yang percaya bilang amin.
If you believe, say amen.
Dengar nih ya, saya
listen.
Selesai yang keempat tadi saya tidak punya waktu.
Sorry, I don't have time for number 4 for testimony.
Langsung 5.
But I will go to the number 5.
Daniel itu.
This Daniel.
Itu salah satu orang yang dibuang ke negeri Aranasi dari Israel, dibuang sebagai tawanan.
Is one of the person who were exiled to the foreign country as the prisoners.
Logika berkata orang yang tawanan yang terbuang itu enggak ada yang bisa respect kepada dia.
Logic says that any exiled person will not get respect for others.
Tapi nyatanya,
apparently the fact was
Daniel dua kali punya kedudukan tinggi.
Two times on a high position
di Babel.
Babel.
Sekarang itu Irak.
Now Babel is Iraq, the country of Iraq.
Dua kali.
Two times.
Dia pernah mendapat jabatan tinggi di kerajaan di Medi Persia yang sekarang namanya Iran.
So he also had two times a high level position in the Medi Persia. Now it's called Iran.
Dengar Bapak Ibu.
Listen.
Doa.
Prayer
kita excellent.
We make us excellent.
Luar biasa. Ketika kita punya roh excellent,
if we have excellent spirit,
kita akan dapat hikmat dari Tuhan.
We will get wisdom from God.
Kita akan dapat kuasa dan otoritas dari
Tuhan. We will get power and authority. authority from God.
Dan bahkan kalau kita punya roh excellent,
and even if we have an excellent spirit,
kita punya semangat untuk berjuang, amen, semangat, amen, untuk belajar, amen, semangat untuk improve ourselves.
We will have the spirit to fight, and we will have spirit to learn, and we will have spirit to prosper.
Saya heran kadang ada orang yang beberapa malas belajar.
I see many people lazy to study.
Malas berjuang.
Lazy to fight.
Malas untuk apa lagi? Malas untuk saudara lihat, malas untuk belajar dan untuk improve dalam hidupnya, ini bikin improvement dalam hidup.
They got lazy to improve in their life.
Hari ini yuk kita berdoa.
Today let's pray.
Supaya kita punya roh yang excellent.
Amen. So we have the excellent spirit.
Yang suci bilang amin.
If you agree, say amen.
Saya minta pemusik bisa.
Yeah, please, the musician ya. Can come back. Thank you.
Kita akan worship kepada Tuhan. Kita akan berdoa sebentar. Pakai waktu.
Let's worship and let's use this time to pray.
Alami Tuhan di tempat ini.
Experience God in this place.
Mari worship leader bisa naik sebentar.
Worship leader can be.
Thank you, Lord.